Very good morning to everyone. My name is Kantilal Joshi and I am presenting my e-submission seminar on the topic Exploring Voltage Source Converter Based TAX Devices with Energy Storage Capability for Improving Power System Performance under the able guidance of Dr. Vinay Chandra. The abstract is the focus is on integration of voltage source converter based TAX controllers, STATCOM SSS and UPFC. With two energy storage devices, namely SMEs, that is superconducting magnetic energy storage, and ultra capacitors, for improving the performance of the system. Especially small signal and large signal stability has been considered in this work. Detailed modeling and simulation of multi machine system, along with the SMEs and ultra capacitor, has been carried out. So the contents are like this. I will start with the research motivation, literature review. Some papers which are important to me are shown here. Then these are the contents. So the main research motivation is like flexible AC transmission system are now maturing to a level wherein they are coming to actual applications even in the Indian context. The voltage source converter based TAX controllers come with a DC link, and this DC link provides us an opportunity to integrate the energy storage devices, because most of the energy storage devices accept and give energy in DC form. So this gives an additional opportunity. So two things, integration of energy storage tanks are two purposes. One is it gives us an opportunity to store energy and harness energy from whatever resources are available. And second is to extend the control capability of existing TAX controllers. So these are the objectives: study of different TAX controllers and the energy storage systems, then modeling of SMEs, and ultra capacitors, detailed models, and modeling of the system along with STATCOM SMEs, UPFC SMEs, and UPFC ultra capacitor combination and their results. So I have considered a few papers here right from 1999 to date which were relevant to my work. All references are not mentioned here. So in 1999 only, when the study by California Energy Commission has mentioned that they have taken a conceptual study of TAX controllers. So UPFC was found to be the best option for increasing the capability of existing system. Then the integration of energy storage system is not new, it has been there since 2000 only. ZAN, etc., in their IEEE PES conference have shown that when SSS is integrated with energy storage, it has a better performance. Then in 2002, another power engineering society meeting, the STATCOM and SMEs was shown for power association only, but single machine infinite bus system was only considered. Then another report came by EPRI in 2005, and this report actually has given the detailed modeling of SMEs and its integration with grid. Another IEEE task force was set for modeling of digital simulation of TAX and custom power controllers, which has again focused on the modeling of the superconducting magnetic energy storage. Then in 2006, hybrid energy storage along with STATCOM was considered. In 2007, there was an IEEE spectrum article, and this literally marked the return of the ultra capacitors. At that time, I was doing my MTech work under Tyree Pearson, so he asked me to work on the ultra capacitors. And ultra capacitors were present earlier also, but now they were in those sizes that they can compete with batteries. This work continued in our IEEE transaction, Helion Z, they have worked on voltage stability. Then these authors, W2, they have a series of three papers. They have given the linear model, which is known as Phillips-Abraham model, for TAX controllers and TAX controllers with energy storage. And a report in 2012 by Power Grid Corporation of India has proposed various locations where the STATCOM is going to be installed and the SPC is going to be installed. So this is one of the motivation. Then few more papers in elsewhere and the transactions on smart grid. Another report by Power Grid Corporation of India in 2014, which is titled as Desert Power India 2050. So again, it focuses on extracting the power from the cold and hot deserts in India and the importance of the reactive power control for that. So here we can see that a lot of work is still going on, and a very recent transaction paper, IEEE transaction paper, that methodology for power oscillation damping using STATCOM with SMEs, this was In 2015, so I have also referred this. So the interest in the topic is still alive and a lot of work is going on. Now, there are two types of tax controllers. Broadly, you can classify them as variable impedance type and VSC based. So in variable impedance type, basically the mechanical switches in the fixed capacitors are removed and there we have the power electronic switches. So we can have this thyristor controlled reactor and DCSC, GCSC, etc. Series as well as shunt devices. Now, the size of these devices is almost same as that of the fixed capacitors. Only thing is that we get a better control capability and a lot of power electronics systems. If we consider voltage source converter based devices, then they have a DC link and this DC link gives us the opportunity to connect energy storage. Also, they have a better performance as compared to SVC. If we talk about the speed of operation and the size is lesser and the speed of operation is much better in VSC devices. So I have focused to use these VSC devices, especially the first three, STATCOM, SSC and UPFC. Because STATCOM is a shunt device, SSC is a series device, and UPFC is a combination of STATCOM and SSC, common DC. Now these are some of the, as per the power grid report which I have discussed earlier, these are the proposed locations in Maharashtra, Jammu and Kashmir, Tamil Nadu, Andhra, Karnataka and Rajasthan. These are the MPR ratings which are proposed of STATCOM in near future. Already there are few TCSCs which are in operation, but these are SVC type devices and so these are the applications, future applications. Now talking about energy storage systems, there are these kind of energy storage systems are prevalent. We have battery, ultracapacitor, SMEs, flywheel, etc. I have focused on ultracapacitors and SMEs. A lot of work has been done in battery energy storage and the technology is well matured. If we talk about the pumped hydro, compressed air, thermal storage, this is for large storage for hours operation. But my focus is on transmission systems, so I have focused on those devices which can operate in, give me megawatts in milliseconds. So SMEs is the best one and the second best can be ultracapacitors. So these are the different types of batteries as on date available in market. Here I will just present a brief comparison of ultracapacitors and batteries. Ultracapacitors can be charged and discharged for any number of cycles. Basically they have a cycle life of more than say 10,000 or 20,000 as on date. Whereas battery if charged more than say 1000 times, full charge to full discharge, it will lose its life. So that is the advantage of the ultracapacitor. Then the charging time is very less. You can flash charge the ultracapacitor. So it won't take too much of time to charge or discharge. So rapid response is possible in ultracapacitors. It can also provide very high discharge currents. So it is not limited that if you draw 10 kilo ampere or 100 kilo ampere, it is not going to affect the life of the ultracapacitor. Only problem is that it comes in very low voltage size. So even now, as on date, the best one that is available is 31 voltage. 31 volt cell with a faradic value of 10,000 farad. So, but the size is very less. It is the size of your tablet. So, it can store half CV square, you can find out that much energy it can store. And the energy density is less, however, power density is very good in ultracapacitors. Now, just a snapshot of different energy storage systems and the comparison. On x axis, I have the power rating in megawatts starting from 1 kilowatt to 1 gigawatt. On y-axis I have the time, so seconds, minutes and hours. So if I talk about the transmission applications wherein I need stability applications, then I can focus on these two devices, that is high power supercapacitors and the superconducting magnetic energy storage. Other devices like the pumped hydro, compressed air and the flow batteries etc. are for higher amount of storage for longer duration. Now this is a simple diagram, but it explains many of the things in my thesis. So, if I talk about a STATCOM, which is a shunt connected device, it can operate only on this line Q. Either it can supply the reactive power or it can absorb the reactive power. That means either it can operate in a inductive mode or in a capacitive mode. And this dashed line, outer dashed circle, shows the MVA rating if I want to control a particular voltage or say particular application. When I add the real power capability to a VSC, then I have E as well as Q, so I can operate in all the quadrants. And the inner circle shows the MVA rating with energy storage. So this means that there is a reduction in MVA rating with the addition of energy storage. So this is an interesting observation that we can reduce the size of the power electronic front end by addition of energy storage. Now, in our we have a lab in our department, batch lab, wherein all four types of devices can be simulated. This STATCOM, SSC, UPFC, and IPFC. It's a very small model. So here I have I'm presenting the results of the STATCOM. It's open loop control. So as I vary the angle, then the sending end current improves, and at a particular angle, your receiving end and sending end voltages are equal, and the DC voltage also varies. Now, in this same panel, what I have done is I have used an ultra capacitor of 430 farad 16 volt. It is a Maxwell made ultra capacitor in our college. So, 430 farad 16 volt ultra capacitor model was connected to the DC link of the voltage source converter, and the voltage was held constant irrespective of the variation of load. So, it extends the control capability of the DC. So, it was established in the lab that this kind of work can be taken further for transmission system. Now, when it comes to the modeling part, so I have considered detailed model as well as the phasor model of the magnet. And I have done extensive literature survey on this and I found that this model is employed by almost all the researchers. That is called as the initially proposed by Zubeda and Bonner. So, ultra capacitors show different response in, if I talk about milliseconds, if I talk about seconds, or if I talk about hours. So, the response of ultra capacitor varies. Especially in transient stability studies, it is important to model the ultra capacitor in this part. So, it has a branch, this is called as the immediate branch. Immediate branch has a resistance Ri, and then there are two capacitors. One is a fixed capacitor, and another is a voltage dependent capacitor. So, this capacitor basically varies with the voltage across the capacitor. So, this differential capacitor is very important if I talk about transient stability. Or stability studies. Then there is a delayed branch, so it's a fixed RC model. Then long term branch, another fixed RC model, and the leakage resistance. So in literature, the parameters for because experimental determination of the parameter was done on a 470 farad ultra capacitor. So the model was like the earlier model which I have shown, these are the parameters for that. And a similar model was developed using the equations, all the equations were used. So, this is the Simulink model. Now, here these are the simple RC models. However, this one, this subsystem which is shown here, is the detailed differential capacitor model. So, the mathematical modeling was done basically 1 by C integral I dt using the basic formula. And since the variable capacitor is not available in MATLAB, so I have prepared my own variable capacitor. And the final result of constant current charging is shown here. So, it takes some around 50 seconds to charge from 0 voltage to 2.25 volts, which is the maximum voltage of the ultra capacitor, and then it starts discharging. Now, this is the comparison with the linear model. So, the blue curve shows the RC model, if I use the RC model, and this is the Zubeda Bonnert model. So, there is a slight exponential curve, and the initial part is like in the initial response is like this, and then slowly saturates. So, this is the difference between the two models. Now, these are the parameters of some of the commercially available ultra capacitors which are available in the market. And these parameters are again derived by experimental studies. So, all these things I have displayed here and I have used in my simulation, different parameters. Now, the second energy storage device which I have considered is the superconducting magnetic energy storage, SMES. Now, the IEEE task force paper which I have shown earlier, they have given this model. So, it is a 6 segment model wherein 6 inductors are used, their self inductance as well as mutual inductance is used, and the capacitances are also used to model the actual structure of the SMEs. So, it is a double pancake structure, so that has been shown here. Now, in this, to model this, I have again used MATLAB for this purpose, and the parameters for a 50 megawatt, 100 megajoule systems. Was taken from the IEEE task force paper, and this is the inductance matrix which was fed to the Simulink model. Again, now this is a these are the 6 inductances, and the mutual inductances can also be specified in this in the matrix form that was done. And the capacitance, this is the subsystem of the capacitance, so 2 ground capacitances and 1 series capacitance is shown. Now, there is a fundamental difference between the ultra capacitor and SMEs. The ultra capacitor works as a voltage source. So, if you want to give energy to the system or extract or charge the system, current direction will change. Whereas in SMES, the direction of voltage has to change if, because it's a current source, because the energy is stored in an inductor. So to achieve that, this interface was developed, three-phase chopper was developed, and this is the SMES model as developed earlier. Now, in this, the duty cycle of the chopper has to be controlled if you want to control the power interface. So from t equal to 0 second to 0.22 seconds, the duty cycle was set to 100% and the current rises from 0 ampere to 400 ampere in this period, whereas the voltage remains minus 25 kV. So it's a 25 kV voltage maintained across the inductor branch. The current rises, so basically this is charging when the duty cycle is set to 100%. Then from 0.22 to 0.8 seconds, 0.28 seconds, the duty cycle was set as 50%. So it's a standby mode. During this period, the SMES will be in the standby mode. So there will be no power exchange with the power system and it will be in the standby mode. And from 0.28 seconds onwards, duty cycle was set to 0. So the voltage will change its polarity. It will now become plus 25 kV and the SMES will start discharging. So this is how the SMES functions and it was modeled in detail as shown earlier. Now, I have studied three different case studies. To start with, I have used the power system stability and control model, which is a standard model of Baikundur. So, four generators of 900 megawatt each are interconnected into two areas. And the system is like the H in this area is slightly more than H in this area. So, basically, it's a, to study the low frequency oscillations, this is a good model. Now, if I talk about the STATCOM control, basically there are two types of controls which are there. One is called as the type 2 control, wherein the value of DC voltage has to be varied. DC link voltage magnitude has to be varied. And here we use the high number of pulse waveform, 48 pulse waveform. Because in multi-megawatt applications, if we go for large switching frequency, too many losses will be there. So the 48 pulse waveform is good so that we can get a sine wave. But now, even the PWM technique is reported in literature with the improvement of the GPOs and all. So here we use the PWM technique to obtain the output and the chopping frequency is still restricted to few kilohertz, not much. And VDC here, DC voltage is fixed and the output is controlled by varying the modulation angle and the phase angle, modulation index and the phase angle. So this is also called as the type 1 control. Now here I am showing the type 1 control which has been used here. So there are basically three controllers. One is called as the AC voltage regulator. So this AC voltage regulator will regulate the voltage at the point where STATCOM is connected and along based on the reference, whatever is the reference. Reference can be derived for various purposes. Then there is a DC voltage regulator which gives us the reference for direct current. So ID reference is derived from the DC voltage regulator. And there is an inner loop, inner control loop, which is called as the current regulator, which ultimately gives the modulation index and phase angle which controls the STATCOM as per the requirement. Now here, because I wanted to interface the energy storage, that is the ultra capacitor, what I did is I have used my own control system like this. So the inner control loop remains the same, that means I am still using the inner control loop as the current controller. However, the outer controller is your power controller. So reference power and actual power, they are compared. Then there is a controller here which derives the ID and then further the chopper control is achieved. So it is shown here, the detailed control scheme is shown here. So the DC voltage regulator is now replaced by the power control block and then we can achieve the results. So there are two studies, one is small signal analysis. Now PSS, that is power system stabilizers, are very common now in power system. They have become default elements in the power systems. So if I talk about the small signal analysis, what I have done is a 5% voltage magnitude pulse was given on generator 1 for 12 cycles. So if the PSS is not present or STATCOM is also not present, the system is naturally unstable for a 5% voltage cycle. If I use, then I am showing the results of all. So this is a local mode between d theta 3 and 4. So system 3 and 4, there are difference in rotor angle. So it is almost like whether we have a STATCOM or STATCOM plus SMES, it is almost same. This is the inter-area mode between machine 1 and machine 4 in area 1 and area 2. So there is a slight decrease in the peak, but there is a with or without STATCOM. But the system is otherwise okay with PSS. So, as such, there is no need of energy storage for this purpose. Now, to study the large signal analysis, what I have done is I have done a three-phase to ground fault by the MATLAB block which is available, reducing the voltage to zero. There is a default resistance as you are asking, sir. It is a 0.01 default ground resistance is there in MATLAB. So, that was used. Now, here interesting thing is, if I do the fault for longer duration, then without STATCOM, even in presence of the PSS, the system is totally unstable. So this is the rotor angle inter-area modes M1 and M4. So the system is totally unstable. With STATCOM, the blue curve shows the result in STATCOM, and the SMES, addition of the SMES improves the peak as well as the damping of the system. So this is the inter-area mode result. Similarly, I have done for local modes. So this is d theta 1-2, so in area 1, local mode, and this is d theta 3 and 4 in area 2, the local mode. So again, the response without STATCOM, the system is anyway unstable, but with STATCOM and with SMES, the performance is improved. Now, how it is happening? So this can be explained. I have tried to superimpose two graphs. So this is not exactly the value of the SMES power. These are just qualitatively explaining. Whenever d delta by dt is increasing, the SMES is working in antipathy to the oscillations. So whenever d delta by dt is increasing, SMES power will become minus. Whenever it is reducing, it will supply. So constant charge discharge will happen in the SMES, which will aid the oscillation damping of the system. This was the first case which I have considered for STATCOM. Then second case, I have used another system where again the complete nonlinear model of the system is used. The generators are modeled in total details. These are the parameters which are shown. And a recent ISOR journal was published in 2015. So I have compared my results with this paper. They have done on a single machine infinite bus system. I have done on a two machine system. So the SMES is again integrated via a DC-DC converter at the DC link, and a UPFC is used. So earlier I have used the STATCOM, here I am using the UPFC. Now the UPFC control, the SMES, yeah, it is connected at bus 2. Actually, the location studies I have done, sir. So in location studies, when I add real power as well as reactive power, location is not an issue at all. And this has also been established by a 2015 paper. If you are only considering reactive power, then midpoint is the issue. But when real and reactive power are being modulated, then you can modulate the control scheme accordingly. So this is the series part of the UPFC. STATCOM control I have already explained in the earlier slides, so I will not repeat it here. In the series part of UPFC, basically we are injecting the voltage in series with the transmission line. So VD and VQ, these are being injected in the line. So VDF and VQF, and accordingly the pulses will be developed. Now the PQ measurement block, real power is shown here, reference power is there, and here I have added the SMES power in this scheme, which controls the VQ. So VQ reference will be modulated as per the requirement of the power, and Q reference anyway VD is there. Now with the addition of energy storage, I can inject the voltage at any angle, not only 90 degrees, it can be injected at any angle. For modeling the SMES, again I have used this, because it's a phasor model, so I have used these equations, basic equations, and as I told you earlier, when duty cycle is 0.5, it's in standby mode. If it is more than 0.5, it will discharge. If it is less than 0.5, it will charge. So these equations were used to develop the model for the system, and this block represents, this blue block represents the SMES model. In this model, the complete the simple equation has been simulated like this. So the 1 minus 2D divided by the VDC, that gives me the current, and the current is in voltage, and voltage is integrated to get the current, and finally the power by voltage into current. This is the series regulator, this is the MATLAB block basically. Okay. So again, I have done three types of studies. One with simple single line to ground fault was done, and to study the impact of whether really STATCOM or UPFC is really required or not, and then a large fault was done for that. So this is at bus B1. I have done a line to ground fault and without UPFC. So no UPFC was there, only power system stabilizer. So it settles down very fast, no problem is there, system is returning to stability. Whereas if I do a three phase to ground fault at bus 1 without UPFC, PSS is there, but without UPFC if I do it, then the system is unstable because it is loaded to its surge impedance loading, almost close to SIL. So system initial conditions have been set to study this kind of response. So the system is unstable. When I connect the UPFC and PSS together, then the system returns to stability, and this is the waveform that I get. This is basically d theta 1 to 2, the difference of the road dynamics. Now, as shown earlier, energy storage was used in antipathy to the oscillations. So this is the response. The blue one is the only UPFC, only with the UPFC, and this is with the UPFC plus SMS, the black one. So we have a reduction in peak as well as the damping is better in the black one response, you can see, with UPFC plus SMS. This is happening because, again, SMS is working in antipathy to the oscillations. So the oscillation damping has been proved here. In addition to that, the critical clearing time also improves. The earlier fault was done for 0.1 seconds on a 60 Hz system. Now this fault has been done for 0.137 seconds. So just to see, at 0.137 seconds, this my system with UPFC, even with UPFC, goes towards unstability. And at this time, at this fault, the system with SMES returns back to stability. So slight increase in critical clearing time is achieved with the help of the SMES also. This is the response of the real power of SMES in antipathy to the oscillations as shown earlier. Terminal voltage and speeds was again seen just to ensure that the system is like stable. Then the third case, the detailed models that I have presented earlier were used in this. So earlier two cases were for simulated using the phasor model. This is here I am using the detailed model. So here the generators are equivalent systems are used and a UPFC is connected between bus B1 and B2.
Close to B1 or close to B2?
The shunt connection is at B1, sir. B1. This UPFC has two this STATCOM and SSC. So shunt controller is
at B1
squarely,
either at B1 or
yes, B1. It is at B1, sir.
B1.
Yes. So the basic purpose of UPFC is power flow control. So just to establish that the power flow control is working fine, I have changed the reference of power from the say 8.5 to 10. And the real power also follows the commanded reference and it achieves in say around 0.15 seconds. So steady state results are good. Then I have done the system under severe fault condition. So this is the system with UPFC. This curve shows the response under 3-phase ground fault. This is P, this is P reference. Now again STATCOM, SSC and UPFC, all three responses were considered together. So UPFC naturally gives better damping as compared to STATCOM and SSC because it has the ability to give real power as well as reactive power, even without energy storage. Then again, the in earlier simulation I have used SMES, here I have used ultracapacitors. Now SMES and ultracapacitors cannot be directly compared because the ultracapacitors still are in that stage where few megawatt application are possible. But just here I have checked it. So the control scheme is general. Again, there is an inner control loop, DC current controller. Here I use the hysteresis controller, and here the PI controller is used based on this the power reference. Based on the oscillation damping, we can derive the power reference, and the actual power is measured, and the chopper control is achieved. Now here is the comparison of UPFC without and with ultracapacitor. So you can see that with ultracapacitor, the damping is much better as compared to without. Then STATCOM, again the STATCOM response is oscillatory as compared to the STATCOM plus ultracapacitor. And same is the case with the SSC. SSC actually energy storage integration is equivalent to UPFC. Not exactly equivalent, but slightly equivalent to UPFC. So it also gives a good damping performance, even though the peak is slightly higher, but the damping performance is good. So I would like to conclude here. So in this work, I have done the review of current status of energy storage devices, and even though only 5% of all energy storage are current contribution of these technologies, like ultracapacitor and SMES is only 5% of overall technologies, but with the rapid rate, like especially smart grid coming up and these oscillation issues becoming more prevalent, they will be in demand. Then FACTS controllers are also matured to a level where they are finding many applications. Here in this work, I have used two energy storage systems, that is ultracapacitor and SMES in detail. Detailed models have been developed and verified. Then steady state results of FACTS controller has been done in the lab with a 430 farad 16 volt ultracapacitor. And results show that it provides a stiff source. And for results significant to real power system, three different cases were studied. and it is observed that UPFC dumping performance is improved, STATCOM oscillation dumping, transient stability is improved, and SSSC voltage support is improved. And with a lot of investment planned in fax controller, because of the renewables integration, etc., energy storage system can provide two kinds of support, one of energy storage and another of value addition to the fax controllers. So, of course, the future work is we can explore with IPFC. Now, IPFC as such, I could not find many applications, is still in the conceptual phase, but maybe it can be explored. Then, integration of BSC with more than one type, like we can have a hybrid energy storage, STATCOM with ultra capacitor plus SMES optimized for a particular application, and higher number of buses, test cases. So, I have done only in these three cases. These are my publications. First one is a transient stability improvement using UPFC SMS in a multi-machine power system, International Journal of Applied Power Engineering in 2016. This is a free journal, sir. Then the latest paper I have done is at the IEEE International Conference at Karur, Tamil Nadu. And this is a paid journal. And as a second author, I have registered long back in 2009, I have presented the concept in the International Conference in 2009. And this was the paper. This has been cited many times. Then the experimental work which we have done has been already reported in two journals, and another paper has been published in 2015. These are my references. So the fax energy storage conceptual design study was done in 1990, and all the references are mentioned in latest 2015.
Questions from audience. Some salient results which you showed me just
last week. Yes, on which my paper is published. So the paper. In a Fizer model, sir. So, if I consider a system without UPFC, I got the review of this IEEE conference.
That's a locally people read. Sometimes you are lucky. You get good reviews, you are lucky. The slide number, if it is very easy, but also
it is actually hidden.
That it helps.
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, in between,
because of the figure, it is hidden.
This is connected at D1 only, you mentioned.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
This UPFC connection at D1. So, this is a UPFC, right?
It is connected at B2, sir.
B2.
Shunt connection is at B2.
But somewhere you mentioned B1. That is different.
Yes, right? S3, sir. That is a third
case. That is different case. Anyway, B2 it is there. Alright. Main aim, what is that it was in this one, when you put UPFC?
The aim was to improve the inter-area oscillation damping and to find out whether we can improve the clearing time, critical clearing time. And the system has been already demonstrated with PSS, it is working fine for short duration faults. But with SMES, whether I can add value to it, that was my investigation.
No, series compensation helps in these things.
Yes.
Because practically it is there in our country.
Yes, PCSCs are there.
In terms. Anyway, this is in addition, shut out, so it's there.
Yeah.
Like that.
The shunt will take care of the voltage at this point.
Mm. But anyway, they are not there. At that voltage level, it will come.
Stat pumps are proposed, sir. UPFC is not there at all. Stat pumps are proposed. 220 kV they are proposed.
Okay, in this system and with this application, you have got some results.
Yes.
Go through the plan. Now, this is what page number?
This is your
slide number?
42.
42. Now you proceed. Let us see. What are the cases?
This is the control scheme, SMES model. This is the impact of PSS on system stability for a simple line to ground port.
But when you have put PSS, means you represented the generator in more detail.
Yes.
Your excitation system.
All complete model.
But how you put it, that one, that model?
I use MATLAB phasor model.
Because standard only.
Yes, sir, but it's a detailed model because earlier results have been on linearized model.
No, the problem is,
and it has
these are all standard existing models. The PSS also.
Yeah, these are standards, so I wanted to compare whether my device is adding value. So I first compared the good system which is already working fine, reported in literature, and then because there is no way I can do it experimentally.
No, what happens is these things, there is a simulator.
Right.
Then you put here and generate some results. But what is that as a researcher you are trying to, which was not there, and this is what happened.
Yes, that is the energy storage parts. Integration of energy storage.
That is a issue.
Yeah, that is what I have shown, sir. That is what I have shown there, sir.
No.
These are the results of UPFC with SMES, the black one, the red one, sir. This one. This is the response of UPFC with SMES. Even if UPFC was not studied earlier, I have studied that, but it is already there. But SMES modeling, SMES integration with UPFC, control scheme development, and then the results.
See, this UPFC, when you put it,
yes,
that shunt part, series part, has certain limitations.
Yes.
Right? Can you tell me what were those limits for this system?
For this system, sir, I have.
For this system, you tell me, because your system I have understood.
Okay, sir.
Then you can go back to this one.
Yeah.
This system is okay. Something and here about 5,000 megawatt, 1,000 megawatt.
Right.
Some system is there, is already. And a long line is there. It's UPFC more or less at the midpoint kind of a thing.
Yes.
What is the UPFC? It's a rating and it's a limits. Because it has limits. Okay? Because this all these devices are very sensitive. They are not that robust. As long as within the limits are there, they are well and good. Otherwise, they are of no use.
Yes.
Okay. I like that. That is the thing. Because without that, if you put SVC as a shunt, that is much better than this one.
Right.
It has a higher capacity. But only
SVC size will be bigger.
Of course, that is a design is different. That one there where the capacitor reactor is there, they are controlled. It is a very huge one. This is a improved design, but limitations are there.
Yes.
So what are those limits you consider for this UPFC? Because now the power wise 5,000 megawatts, which maybe initially before you create some case, how much that generator was giving, how much this was giving. Because some power transfer also it.
Sir, it is loaded at 977 megahertz, close to 977 megahertz.
Which one?
The power from G1 to
G2. 977.
Yes, megahertz.
Why 977? Because this is a, this you reduce data.
No, from here to here. From G1 to G2. I wanted to study the inter area. This.
Right.
And this generator is supplying here, which is already rated at a higher value.
That is around 4,000, right?
Transmission line is loaded to its surge impedance load. Near to surge impedance.
Where surge impedance? You were saying about 1,000 megawatts.
Yes.
The signal circuit will take 1,000 megawatts.
Sir, this line is taking close to 977 megawatts, around 950 megawatts in this transfer in the
state. 500 kVs.
Yes.
And 500 kV system, it may be double circuited.
No, sir. Single circuit.
A single circuit to 500 kV, 500 megawatts. How will you take double 977? You check up.
500 kV, 700 kilometer line, sir.
Approximately it is like that, 500 kV, 500 megawatts. Yes, it can vary. Rating approximately 2000 megawatts, it cannot transfer. It must be double circuit. You check up. Okay. So, now you tell me the limit service. UPFC.
The limits like STATCOM, we have a shunt
device. No, this one, this US. B2,
yeah.
You connected it B2, right?
Right.
So, there is a series is there. This from B2 to B3 or B3 to B2, whatever you call. It can control, right? And there must be double circuit, otherwise its control has no meaning. Because when you control it, power should flow in other place. If you want to increase the flow, where it will go, the remaining one. Parallel path is there.
No, no. Actually, what happens, sir, the fundamental use of UPFC is like, you can inject the voltage at any angle. So, like you use a TCSC, so it is working like either inductor or capacitor. Here, by injecting the real power, which is drawn from the STATCOM itself, line itself the power is drawn, at injected at any angle. So, you have extended control level. That is the advantage of UPFC. What you are saying is that two parallel lines are there and you can control the impedance of one line, which will have the power flow in another line. That is right, sir. But here the purpose is we inject it, can be injected at any angle. With reference to?
Current. Small range.
Yeah, the range is very small.
Sir. Very range smart is small. Range.
Because even in the Indian power system, the fixed capacitors are of higher value and the MVR rating is less. No, what I have considered is here,
what are the limits?
500 MVR I use.
500
kV. 500 kV. And the shunt device is 100 MVR. Sorry. And the series device is also 100 MVR. I have separated it in the way that I get a steady state response.
But these are all somewhere you have got the from literature this
yes.
Value
yes.
Or this UPFC.
Yes. This is a published paper.
And the angle limits, how much it was there?
Angle limits?
Because this shunt impedance, its angle is there. Series impedance, its angle is there. What was the range?
Series impedance will not have any problems. It can inject at any angle, that's what I'm saying. 360 degrees we can inject. No, I mean, if I talk about the UPFC operations.
Anyway, your results should show whatever.
Right.
Come to the result part. What is this one?
This is simple LG fault done at bus B1.
At
bus?
B1.
B1.
LG fault. Then, what you did?
Then the three phase to ground fault at B1.
No, previous one. This one. LG fault at B1.
So, this is stable with BSS only. There is no need of UPFC as such. So, small yeah. Fault. It can take care on its own. The original system which was there in the literature can take care of its own.
Okay.
And with three phase fault for 0.1 seconds, the system is unstable.
Which is unstable?
This is the rotor angle between machine 1 and 2.
For which is disturbance?
Three phase to ground fault at bus B1.
It is unstable.
Yes.
Why it is unstable? I don't know. It is a 5000 megawatt capacity and
Because the transmission line is loaded close to the SILs. That is the reason. So it is almost on the verge of that instability. It has been made like that. Load flow has been set to that way that it is almost close to verge of instability. And now I am checking.
This is with UPFC.
With UPFC?
This is with UPFC and the same case is there without UPFC.
Yes, earlier one was the without UPFC.
You could have put it compared like that.
Yes, I have compared in the last one. Here I have compared all. Only UPFC, UPFC with SMES. And this is without UPFC, anyway, the system is unstable. So I have not shown that.
But that unstable case I have not able to digest.
I can show the simulation, sir.
You show the diagram?
Yes.
No, not this one. What is this? This is angle.
Rotor angle, sir. Between bus d theta 1 to 2. Machine 1 and 2.
But what is that? 200, 400?
No, no, because it is unstable. So after say 0.6 second, because it's a simulation, I can show longer results. Otherwise, it is like beyond 180, I would stop the simulation.
No, this is not possible
because it's a simulation, I have extended the time.
No, your simulation, that inside program itself is wrong, I can assure you. With the time domain when you try to do it, you will never get this thing of in time domain. That is a time domain.
Yes.
It's not algebraic analysis. Okay. That is different. And this is with respect to time.
Yes.
You are looking at the angle where it will get. No solution will come.
It is, sir, that slight increase in critical clearing time. I mean, the margin of stability has improved with SMES as compared to only UPFC.
Unstable case is very difficult to digest. Some improvement you can tell, but the existing system is becoming unstable to tell. And with the UPFC, it becomes a stable, this is not understandable.
Because, sir, it is rapidly restoring the voltage. I am telling you the reason.
UPFC capacity is what? What device it has got?
I am telling you, sir. At this point, bus B2, I am looking at the shunt device.
As a energy, some source, what it has got to do it? Something to hold a little bit voltage. Maybe the power flow distributing can control.
So that is what is there, sir. There is an incremental improvement. I am not
sure. Ah, that incremental improvement thing, the unstable case to make stable,
sir,
this is
simple
not,
logic is there.
No, usually this is thousands of megawatts.
So I am telling you that because of the rapid restoration of voltage at bus B2 by the shunt device. Because it's a STATCOM, it can operate in milliseconds. So it can rapidly restore the voltage at this point.
It is a questionable one.
Yes.
Yes, some improvement is there, you can tell.
Yeah.
But the system which was unstable, with this I made it stable, that is very good.
Yes. Okay. I'll take it in a positive way, sir.
Yeah. Anyway, it is because 5,000 megawatts you have to take. When it is close to that bus, you have to take. Otherwise, that line, if the load is at B2, it cannot feed the line itself. So,
that's
the way you have conditions are like that.
That I'll have to try and see.
That is why you are trying to convey, which is not much relevant. Okay? If the system can make it stable to unstable because of the way you consider it is
that is
your game.
Yes.
Right? any questions from audience? Again, repetition. There are India in the home. Right. Okay, thank you.